Good morning all of you. Today's session is for class 7 and the topic present in synopsis 4, page number C23. The topic is osmotic pressure. It is one of the colligative property. Colligative property, the properties at which the physical and chemical properties of solution only depending upon the number of particles of solute but not on the nature of the solute. Hence, such properties are known as colligative properties. Out of that four colligative properties, first one, RLVP, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second one, depression in freezing point. Third one, elevation of boiling point. Coming to fourth one, that is osmotic pressure. Before entering into the osmotic pressure, we have to know the definition of osmosis. Osmosis is nothing but flow of solvent molecule into the solution is known as osmosis. Nothing but when the two solutions are connected to each other with the same non-volatile solute at different concentrations. Nothing but the flow of solvent from dilute solution to the concentrated solution. The flow is known as osmosis. Nothing but here, osmotic pressure represented by the symbol pi. Now, the pressure at which the solvent molecules are getting back from the solution of higher concentration. Nothing but high concentration solution to the low concentration solution, the solvent molecules are moving. Then the applying pressure is known as osmotic pressure. Now osmotic pressure in terms of either atmosphere or dying per centimeter square or mm of Hg. Now coming to the representation, while taking a beaker with some quantity of solvent, inserting a thistle funnel that can have the semi-permeable membrane. Now the thistle funnel is filled with the solution of a high concentration. Nothing but here the solvent molecules are going into the solution by passing through the semi-permeable membrane. Now while comparing with the level of the water and the level of solution in the thistle funnel, the difference is represented by the osmotic pressure P, that can be given as HDG. H represents the height of the solution, D represents the density of the solution, and G is acceleration due to gravity. When the two solutions are connected, that can be separated by the semi-permeable membrane. Now at the first solution it may have only solvent molecules, and the second one it may have the solution. These solvent molecules are passing through the semi-permeable membrane into the solution. Now while applying the pressure on that solution. Now while entering the solvent molecules, the level of the solution increases to somewhat higher extent. That change in level that can have the pressure represented by osmotic pressure P. Now to get the solvent molecules back, we have to apply some quantity of pressure. Along with the pressure of the solution. Nothing but P plus pi. Now here initially it may have only the pressure P. Now the applying of osmotic pressure to get back the solvent molecules is known as osmotic pressure. Now coming to the reverse osmosis. Reverse osmosis is explained by the desalinization of water. desalination of water. Nothing but the solutions of fresh water and salt water are separated by the semi-permeable membrane, SPM. Now, by using the piston, applying the pressure on the salt solution to get back the solvent molecules and the water getting outlet. This process is known as reverse osmosis. Now coming to the applications, nothing but here, first application is rise of water in the plants, nothing but from bottom to the leaves by the osmosis process. Second one is here, raw mango when it is soaked in the highly concentrated salt solution, nothing but it may convert into pickle. The formation of pickle from the raw mango is can be explained by the osmosis process, but the osmosis does not observed in the same as like that in case of living organisms. In living organisms, it is followed by two methods. Those are homolysis and plasmolysis. Homolysis, nothing but here, the contents flow into the cell. Now plasmolysis represents contents flow from the cell. Now coming to the Van't Hoff's law is one of the derivation getting from the osmosis. First of all, the osmosis was explained by Abbé Nolet in the year 1745. According to Van't Hoff's law, the osmotic pressure is directly proportional to temperature in Kelvin. Osmotic pressure is inversely proportional to volume of the solution. While combining the above two equations, then you may get pi is directly proportional to T by V. Now 1 by V is considered as concentration of the solution, represented by C, concentration of solution of 1 mole. Then it can be replaced as pi directly proportional to C into T. While eliminating proportionality, pi equal to S C T. S represents here gas constant. Sometimes the S may equal to R, universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. And now here pi equal to C R T. R represents gas constant. Now C, that can be written as N by V, number of moles present in volume of solution, R into T. From this one, pi V equal to N R T. Then finally pi V equal to weight by gram molecular weight of solute, R T. From this one, M equal to W R T by pi V. Now whereas here, that M represents molecular weight of solute. Nothing but the unknown solute of its gram molecular weight can be found out by the Van't Hoff's law according to the osmotic pressure. Now what are the relative terms here? Relative terms, it may have two conditions. Nothing but the osmotic pressure of first solution may less than or greater than osmotic pressure of second solution. Osmotic pressure of second solution. Nothing but here, that can have high concentration. Solution that can have high concentration in terms of weight by volume percentage. Approximately it is greater than 0.9 weight by volume percentage. Then that solutions are known as hypertonic solutions. Hypertonic solutions with NaCl. Now similarly, the solution that can have less concentration less than 0.9 weight by volume percentage of NaCl as a solute, then that solutions are known as hypotonic solution. Hypotonic solution. It is one of the first application. Now second application is isotonic solutions. Isotonic solutions, the solutions that are equal in concentration, equal in osmotic pressure, nothing but pi 1 equal to pi 2. Isotonic solutions also again may classified into two conditions: at same temperature, at different temperature. Nothing but for first solution it can be written as pi 1 equal to C1 or T1, pi 2 equal to C2 or T2, C2 or T2. Then according to isotonic rule, pi 1 equal to pi 2, pi 1 equal to pi 2, osmotic pressures are equal. Then now as earlier we discussed that one, temperatures also same. Therefore C1 or T1 equal to C2 or T2. Temperatures can get cancelled each other, R also can get cancelled each other, then finally you will get the equation C1 equal to C2. Nothing but their concentrations are equal. For that, a best example is 0.3 molarity of glucose. Best example is 0.3 molarity of glucose is in isotonic with the 0.3 molarity of fructose. Fructose, because the glucose and fructose that can have the same molecular formula. What is that molecular formula? C6H12O6. C6H12O6. Nothing but here the molecules are equal. Number of solute particles are equal with equal concentration. Hence the two solutions are isotonic with each other. Now while taking 0.3 molarity of glucose with the 0.3 molarity of NaCl. 0.3 molarity of NaCl. NaCl is ionic compound. It may divide into two types of ions. Nothing but the number of solute particles of glucose that are not equal with the solute particles of NaCl. Hence, the two solutions are not isotonic, even though that can have the same concentration. Now, with respect to different temperatures, pi 1 equal to C1 R T1, pi 2 equal to C2 R T2. Now, as earlier discussed that one, for isotonic solution, the major condition is the osmotic pressures are equal, pi 1 equal to pi 2. Therefore, C1 R T1 equal to C2 R T2. From this one, R and R may get cancel each other. Then you may get C1 by C2 equal to T2 by T1. Nothing but concentration of the solution is high and the temperature is low. If the concentration of solution is less, then the temperature will be high from the above relation. These are the relative terms with respect to the osmotic pressure. Now in this session, we have discussed the osmotic pressure, definition of osmosis and the relative applications, and the diagrammatical representation of reverse osmosis. Now identical solutions of same concentration to show the atmospheric pressure equal to vapor pressure. Nothing but applying osmotic pressure. Now the derivation of calculation of molecular weight of unknown solute from the osmotic pressure is given by the Van der Waals law. And the relative terms in the Van der Waals law. Solutions are less than or greater than with the concentration, and the solutions are having with equal concentration with the same osmotic pressure. Thanks for watching.